country is not the only place we can use these pretty baskets in. Here's a new way to style our fridge functionally. With a fridge that is this small, keeping tomatoes in the veggie bin leaves almost no space for other veggies. I find myself guilty of leaving tomatoes inside, often found crushed beneath bulkier veggies. Separating tomatoes here makes for more space in the veggie bin, and now I'm able to simply pick and store tomatoes back in this basket quite swiftly. Considering these tips are for a super tiny fridge, I would recommend against using egg trays, only because of the amount of space they take. In my case, these trays took up one full shelf worth of real estate on this fridge door, which wasn't functional at all. So even with no eggs in the tray, I could not use that space for anything else. Utilizing bins like so make for a wonderful cavity in the same shelf where the eggs fit snugly, leaving a lot more room for other things on the same shelf. Mind you, if your household consumes and stores way more eggs, then I feel stackable egg trays with lids can solve the purpose too. This holder is used to organize dish sponge in the sink area, but it found a new spot in my home. Often a fridge gets messy not because of the food we take in and bring out, but because of the smaller packets, sauces, dips, etc. that are found randomly. Having all those extra mayo and sauce packets, sometimes even cheese slices over here, in front of my eyes ensures that they get used up quite fast. Not having a good sense of things we have in our fridge does not help. But it happens to all of us quite often, mostly when there are lots of veggies hidden at the back of the shelf. It's quite common with infrequent shoppers like me. To mitigate this, I like to keep some but not all veggies chopped and ready for the coming days. This includes some basic herbs, greens, etc. I do not promote pre-cutting veggies for long, but it's something I resort to for optimizing my storage and also as a part of meal planning. See-through boxes have made my life much easier with this, although it would have been even better if one could use glass containers. Dedicating the bottom shelf for this and leaving some extra space at the back for more items if need be really helps. The boxes kept in front always help to grab and go at ease. Kitchen napkins achieve multiple purposes over here. One to begin with is that they keep the base clean, and each time we fill it up with fresh stock, we can simply remove these. Second, they help in absorbing extra moisture, keeping the veggies fresh for longer. And third, they provide for a white base which makes veggies clearly visible. In my opinion, a packed fridge becomes a disorganized fridge very quickly, which leads to food wastage. But that doesn't mean you have to buy things more frequently and that you can't stock up. Keeping veggies in net bags not only keeps them divided, but also helps to see what's inside. Although there are cotton bags coming out in the market for the same purpose, but unfortunately I couldn't find one that allows me to see the contents of the bag without opening it. Till then, my good old net bags are doing the job very well. Having a smaller fridge makes you want to keep things compact, and not just that, keeping things in dedicated compartments helps even further with that. Here I am repurposing a small cornflakes package only to create a small section for my sauces. Since they don't have a firm base, they keep toppling over, so this small trick really helps. You could use them in multiple ways, you know. Additionally, I like to use bins that come with veggies and fruits to make my own compartments. But there are many clear acrylic bins out there that one can buy to make this step more durable. Having an idea of which part of your fridge is meant for what things really helps in the long run. But defining the space into compartments with such bins ensures that the other members of the household also keep things in the set compartments. If compartments are too difficult to create, then making broader zones with broader categories can also help with effective organizing. Little tricks here and there can be useful to increase the shelf life of vegetables that we want to have handy. For instance, carrots, if peeled and stored in water, stay on much longer. Removing florets and storing in a box with lid gets rid of the bulkiness, making storage much easier. Again, these tricks apply for people who have a tiny fridge and find it difficult to store veggies altogether. Additionally, having boxes for storing every little thing is not really feasible all the time. At such times, I feel beeswax paper comes in handy to cover up things that we know we will be consuming soon. The point here is to try and utilize maximum space possible, but still avoid overstuffing and be within the budget limits whenever possible. For a small fridge like this, keeping things minimally is the best bet. But at times, when there are more things to store, small tricks can be a big savior. a juice carton once opened has a limited shelf life, which is why moving it into a transparent glass bottle ensures that we consume it well in time. While any sort of organizing can beautify things, but it becomes essential to ensure the usability factor as well. All of it is done only to avoid wastage, keep ingredients fresh, and consume things on time. This tip above comes with the same thought process in mind. I like to make my own little basket where I can store my cheese slices, cheese cubes, stock cubes and other such things. Keeping things in a basket keeps them tucked away, so we pull this basket out only when particularly needed for a recipe. At the same time, they do not come in the way of other things. Lining baskets is a good idea to protect them from spills. Pamphlets like these are quite thick compared to just placing a paper napkin. They do the job well and they can be easily replaced as well. While many such boxes in our arsenal can be used to store food, some are certainly better suited for the task than others. These large, at the same time squarish shaped boxes make for better usage of space and also provide for a uniformity in the overall look. Some things never leave our fridge. Ginger and lemon are one of those things. So I keep them handy but out of the way by using this smaller section of the door, making them easy to access. If you have some things that are on top of the list of things to be consumed, they can come right here. The fridge door always gets our attention each time we open it. So I like to keep my old fruits that I feel need to be consumed first thing right at this spot. If you have a freezer like mine, I'm sure you can feel me. The struggle is real, folks. The best way I found to store things in here, especially my peas and beans, is by transferring them to a Ziploc bag. It's easy to use zip pouches as they can be resealed after each use, which also means no spillage. Alongside, I used up the carton again to store our ice cream packs vertically, making for more space on the right hand side. After all the efforts that we take to keep the fridge odorless is an added bonus. Using baking soda does the trick without any fuss. One of the most effective techniques for me has been using butter or parchment paper cutouts on the base of the butter dish. This helps in easy cleanup and provides for easy refilling without having to wash the dish each time we fill it back in. Tried making this part of the fridge aesthetically pleasing along with being functional. These baskets give a nice bohemian vibe to the fridge while not making it look boring or dull. So folks, these were some of the tricks I use to keep my tiny fridge organized and functional. Please drop me a comment with the tip that you liked the most out of all. Till then, see ya later!